This video is going to cover binary ionic compounds and how to name them using the stock system. The rule is the cation, your positive ion's name first, and the anion's name second. So first name, last name. Positive ion, negative ion. Monatomic cations take the name of the element. So the first name is just the element, like Na plus is going to be called sodium. Ca2 plus we're just going to call calcium. Step number three, or rule number three. Monatomic anions, so your negative ions, take the element's name and you end it with ide. So the last name is going to end in ide. So Cl minus, the negative ion is going to end in ide, so chloride. So when you put it together, NaCl is sodium chloride, and Li3N is lithium nitride. Note, Greek prefixes are not used to indicate the number of atom of each element in the formula unit for the compound. It's the responsibility of the person writing the formula from the name that has to figure that out. Another example, Na2O is named sodium oxide, not disodium oxide, so no prefixes. Let's name these. I have five examples here. All you do is you name your first element, so Li2O. Li is lithium, and O is oxygen, but we're going to put that ide ending and make it sound correct, so it's going to be oxide. CaBr2, the cation, the positive element, is calcium. So you just write that. And Br is bromine, but that becomes bromide. Al2S, the Al is the positive ion, so we're just going to name that aluminum. And S is sulfur, and that turns into sulfur. Sometimes you got to say it a few times in your head to get it. Mg3N2, the Mg is magnesium. And N is nitrogen, and that turns into nitride. And ZnCl, Zn is zinc. And chlorine turns into chloride. And that's how you name binary ionic compounds using the stock system.